How's it going, guys? I hope you're all doing very well this Easter weekend. I'm Viper, and welcome to the channel. Now, today we are doing the Prophecy Dungeon for an 8-year-old. He dropped me a message asking if I can help him do the dungeon, and as you all know, just drop me a message and I'll come along and help you with whatever you need to do. So he dropped me a message, and now we're diving straight into Prophecy Dungeon, as you can see on the screen, and we're going to get him his first ever dungeon completion. So, big shout out to SpinalLime, the 8-year-old that we are doing the dungeon for, and what most of this video is about. And also a big massive shout out to Convict86 as well for assisting me in doing this dungeon. I'll do like the video, guys, and I will jump in every now and then within the video just to let you know what's going on in that lot, because there's parts where like I explained to him and stuff, and obviously this was not streamed, it was a private game between three of us. I do like the video, guys, and I'll now shut up and you can watch. And here we are at the first boss. Now, I am explaining to SpinalLime about how to get the moats. I'm not going to explain that here because I'm sure you guys are all aware. And to just not to pick any up if he sees any on the floor. And myself and Convict will do it. And just tell him when it's the damage phase on the boss. And not to worry if he dies. He's well under power. He's like 150 points under power or something. He's in Datto gear, you know what I mean? He's only just started it. So we say to him basically, just stay alive. Don't worry if you die. We'll get you back up. And we'll tell you when it's the damage phase. And then just to damage the boss, and then we can go on to the next part. So enjoy, guys.
Thank you.
And here we are now coming up to the part where you dunk the moats and teleport to the next floor. And I'm just explaining to SpinalLime again to don't worry about the moats. Convicts will shoot the taking hobgoblins, the snipers, and then either one of us will pick the moats up and dunk them where they need to go, and then just to go to the middle whenever we say to go to the middle. And then when the boss comes, we just shout, right, just damage the boss, which obviously doesn't take too long. So let's get this part done, eh?
Guardian down. Thank you.
So here we are, we have now completed the transport room with the two bosses at the end of it completed, and we've just got the chest, and I'm just explaining to SpinalLime that I am now going to go ahead and get the ribbon road part done, so because obviously I have a lot more experience than Convict does on that, and obviously SpinalLime has zero experience on it, so I expect them to die quite a fair few times. So I'm just going to quickly go ahead here now and get all the way through the ribbon road and pull them through to the park just before the bosses, after you just kill all them thrall just before you do go up to the final boss arena. So as you can see here, Convict is showing SpinalLime the way to go whilst I go ahead and get to the point where I can pull them through. So cheers for that, Convict mate, saved a lot of time in this video. And for you wild old cats who have done the Prophecy Dungeon quite a fair few times, please feel free to fast forward this part to the boss fight coming up in roughly 2 or 3 minutes time.
guardian down. Guardian down.
Now at this point, obviously, SpinalLime was finding this part a little bit difficult. He's only 8 years old after all, and I was explaining to him, don't worry about not being able to make it down here, because as soon as I get through the teleport bit which takes me up in that tractor beam, I'll be able to pull him through, so he won't have to do all of this jumpy part, which was finding a little bit hard to do this parkouring, which he is a warlock, and I understand I do mess a few jumps up myself with a warlock, especially being on the controller as well. So yeah, I do understand your pain there, SlimeLime, mate. It is a little bit tricky with the warlock sometimes with the jumping, but it's not fair, mate. You're going to get pulled through very shortly anyway. When I got to the tractor beam and it wasn't picking me up, I was thinking, what? Why is it not working? It's the first time this ever actually happened to me. I usually always go up in the tractor beam straight away, so a little bit of a second or two thinking, why is this not working? But yeah, everything sorts itself out, so everything's all fine. And here we are, guys, at the final boss arena. So I'm explaining to SpinalLime the same as what to do with the moats and that lot. I'm basically just explaining to him to just try and stay alive as long as he can, and that myself and Convict will do the moats and then kill the ogre that appears once we've done the moats in each corresponding pillar of light or dark. Now, Convict does forget about this, but he's only done Prophecy, I think, 3 times. I think this was his 3rd time we did Prophecy, so he did actually forget about the ogre that appears when he dunks the ball. But everything was okay, and as you see, it all works out all okay. So let's get this final boss killed, and then I'll come in at the end and have a little chat with yourselves about it. And there you have it, SpinalLime, mate. That is your very first dungeon ever done. And oops, I didn't mean to fall off there at the end, didn't we, Super? It would have been terrible if we had to do it all again. But yes, that's your very first dungeon done there, mate. And I enjoyed doing it with you, mate. I really did. It was been fun. Convict also enjoyed it himself. It was really fun. We actually smashed through it quite fast, actually. It was a little bit quicker than what I thought it was going to take. So that was all good in the end. And you got yourself some gear from the Prophecy Dungeon as well. So thanks for coming along, guys. I really do appreciate that you watched the video. And if you want to play a game of Destiny or Dungeon Raid or anything like that, just drop me a message in game or go down into the comments, post a comment there. I'll end up seeing it and then I'll message you or something, and we can arrange something that can do a dungeon with one of you guys as well. And as always, thanks again for coming and watching, and I shall see you all on the battlefield. And before I do go, quick word from my sponsor, the like button. So go down there, smash the little guy in the face. He's the only sponsor that I do have, which ain't really a sponsor. But yeah, and if you did like it, please subscribe. It helps me out a hell of a lot here at the channel. I am trying to push for 100 subscribers, and I can do a little thank you video to all you subscribers. And again, I really do appreciate you coming along and watching and liking and all that jazz. Really do appreciate it. This is Viper signing out. And as always, eyes up, Guardian. Viper out.